Diego Corrales fought a little bit earlier this evening against a guy by the name of Rocky Cassiani, and we're going to show you exactly what happened in that fight and how it unfolded, because Diego Corrales coming into the fight was really a terrific fighter. He had a tremendous career, and then he ran into problems, a few domestic problems, and he ended up in a situation where he was incarcerated for about a year, and he had to serve that time, and he came back hopefully a better man, and certainly he looks to be a terrific fighter, as at one time he was a world champion. We're going to take a look at the tail of the tape, and we can tell you a few things when we see it, that Diego Corrales is a little bit of a bigger man than Rocky Cassiani, and you'll see that as the fight unfolds, as we replay it for you. Diego Corrales coming into this fight with a record of 34-1. As you see the tail of the tape, you can see he's about 3.5 inches taller. He's a couple of pounds lighter than his Cassiani. He's 9 years younger. Remember, Corrales is only 25 years of age, and he has a 2 inches advantage in reach, and that's something that, as you'll see, he's able to take advantage of as the fight unfolds. Corrales and Cassiani, a terrific fight coming up for you, as we'll show you the replay. These were the rules under which it was contested, the 10-point must scoring system. There is a standing 8 count. There is a 3-knockdown rule in the state of Tennessee. You can be saved by the bell in the last round only, and only the referee can stop the fight. So we're just about set to go as we get ready to go to the Diego Corrales, Rocky Cassiani fight. This is the way I called it when we did it just a short time ago. Here it is. Corrales and Cassiani. Round of the scheduled 10-round affair in the lightweight division. Diego Corrales, decked out in the black trunks with the red trim. He's a former IBF 130-pound world champion. He had 3 successful title defenses at that weight. He was 33-0 with 27 knockouts and a champion at just 23 years of age before he lost that devastating loss to Floyd Mayweather when he was down 5 times and finally stopped in the 10th round of that fight. Rocky Cassiano, in his own right, is a pretty good fighter. He's had, here we are right away with a low blow that starts things off here off the hands of Cassiani, and the referee Bruce Foster will give Diego Corrales all the time he wants and tell him he's got to keep him up. By the way, the rules here in the state of Tennessee, a little bit different. The fight is sanctioned by the Tennessee State Boxing Commission, which is in the Department of Commerce and Insurance. There is a standing 8 count. There is a 3-knockdown rule. a fighter can be saved by the bell in the final round only, and it becomes an official fight once the fourth round starts. So you must get three complete, and then the fourth must start. And Corrales taking his time after that low blow, and Corrales seems to be all set, and Cassiani, more important, seems to be set now. So here we go, right away, right back to it is Cassiani with a good shot. You see the hand speed of the former champ, Diego Corrales, and that's the big difference in the fight. Cassiani has a pretty good record of 21-10-1 with 15 knockouts, but Corrales is 34-1 with just that one loss that I mentioned at the hands of the great Floyd Mayweather. This is his second fight back after a one-year prison sentence that he had to serve time for spousal abuse for domestic violence. And he had a fight just a couple of weeks ago on January 25th in Atlantic City in which he stopped Mike Davis in three rounds. And in all honesty, we don't expect this fight to go too far either, because Corrales really is a world-class fighter. And his promoter, Gary Shaw, expects him to have three or four more fights and maybe ready for a world title shot before the end of the year. That's the kind of class that Diego Corrales has. Corrales is to the right of your screen with all the tattoos on him in the black trunks, and that's Rocky Cassiano in the white trunks, who just took that pretty good right hand to the left side of his head.
Give me a clean break. Step back.
Cassiano was stopped by Ernesto Zapata a couple of years ago, and since then he's 2-3 wins. He went 12 good rounds in May of 2000 with the now world champ Juan Manuel Marquez, the new IBF featherweight champion. So he can give you some rounds ordinarily, but Diego Corrales is a very special fighter. He's a terrific fighter.
Give me a break. Step back.
Rocky, by the way, after being going down with that low blow, used only 38 seconds of the allotted 5 minutes that he could have taken for that low blow, so he wanted to get right back at it. Rocky wide with those left hooks as Corrales, a very disciplined fighter, the hands right together, held high, jabs high with that left hand, puts it in the face of Cassiani, then bangs him right behind the left ear, and now he just waits for the referee, Bruce Foster of Raleigh, North Carolina, to let them get back and separate the two guys. This guy knows exactly what he's doing in there. He's a consummate professional. He felt for his fight a couple of weeks ago that he's not really fine-tuned. He, as I mentioned, he got out of incarceration last June, but he had his first fight just a couple of weeks ago, and he looks pretty good right now as he's unleashing shots left and right here to the head of Cassiani, and the bell ends round number one. That's a good Diego Corrales first round. And for all the ring rust that we talked about yesterday in the conversations, he doesn't look like he's too rusty to me right now. He seems to be very sharp with his punches. The book on him is he's a very aggressive, as you can see. He's a good body puncher. He has all the tools. Before the Mayweather fight, Corrales was actually as high as number 5 on the world pound-for-pound list. So this is a good one. And there he is. Has Kenny Adams in there with him, and Danny Smith, and Andrew Riggins worked the corner. Now watch the low blow. We'll see it nice and clear here. And it's right there. And you can see the immediate reaction by Rocky Cassiano. Cassiani felt that, but he only took, as I mentioned, the 38 seconds to get back up when he could have taken the full 5 minutes. So he wants to go. Now, there seems to be a problem with either his shoulder or his elbow. Perhaps his elbow, the doctor is in the corner. And he may have hyperextended that elbow. He's not going to be able to continue.
Well, I can't feel for sure. It could be a bad.
That's the doctor right there.
That kind of pain. Okay, bend it one more time for him. Never mind.
He bend it?
He can't.
No, he's not going to be able to continue. They have to stop the fight. He's in tremendous pain. To me, it looks like a hyperextended elbow, and the doctor, who was right in there, felt all around and could feel the pressure points and whatnot, and just, I mean, this guy is in a lot of pain. And you can see the way he's holding it. There's just no way he can continue. So it's going to be scored as a technical knockout after one round. And we're hoping Cassiani would give him a few rounds, but that's just a sin that we couldn't get to see Diego Corrales work a little bit more. We're going to take a look at the tail end of the round on the replay here and see if we see anything with that elbow. See, through the elbow, it looked like he whipped it around there, but nothing shows right now. the right elbow we're looking for.
Baby, got to go to work.
Does he get hit on it? No. I mean, Corrales is all over him. And just Corrales landing shots, but I can't see anything on that elbow or any sort of hyperextension. And he's holding it, you know, in kind of a strange situation right there. He backed off the rope. It's just all Diego Corrales, unless he get hit on top of it and a pinched nerve or something of that nature. There's just no way of knowing for sure what the problem is. And he just piles away and continues to throw shots at him, and the possible hyperextension, a dislocation of that elbow is the cause of the stoppage of the fight. It'll be scored, as I said, a TKO at the end of the first round, and we'll get the official particulars momentarily from our ring announcer, Greg Gaston. But the fight is over, and Diego Corrales has won the fight. And as I said, looked like some sort of hyperextension or maybe even a dislocation. Who knows? Okay, our ring announcer is standing by, and we'll get the official particulars as we go to our ring announcer, Greg Gaston.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the advice of the ringside physician, Rocky Cassiano sustained a dislocated right elbow and could not answer the bell for the second round. The winner by technical knockout in the first round, Diego Corrales.
Well, you get the story, and Diego Corrales is the TKO victory, gets the TKO victory after the first round, and again, it's kind of a sin because I would like to see him get a little bit more work, and certainly Rocky Cassiano is the type of guy that could have given him a little bit more work, but there's just no way, as you see that elbow, that he could continue. So the doctor in attendance had to advise the referee, Bruce Foster, that the fight had to be stopped because this guy is in definite pain. And Diego Corrales, two for two since his comeback. In about 3 weeks, he's had two big wins. So you'll see a lot more of Diego Corrales. And again, as we talked to his promoter, Gary Shaw, yesterday, Gary said that I think that, you know, two or three more warm-up fights, although he was expecting to get some rounds out of Cassiani, who's had sort of an up-and-down career since he fought Wilfredo Vasquez for the WBA featherweight title in New York. And since then, he's been kind of on the up-and-down sort of career, but nothing like he was leading up to his shot against Wilfredo Vasquez for the WBA featherweight title. But nonetheless, it's all over. It's disappointing to all of us that Diego Corrales only had the opportunity to go just the one round, but it was obvious to me in the first round that Diego Corrales was not showing a lot of ring rust against Rocky Cassiani. I'm going to show you another replay that'll show you a big miss by Rocky Cassiani, and possibly he could have dislocated it then. Watch this, kind of a windmill right there, and he missed, and he ducks down, and he doesn't show any sort of grimacing in the face at this stage. He holds his hands up high, and he doesn't appear, to my recollection, that he gets hit on that elbow at all. So, I mean, of all the things that we saw, and we'll show you a different angle of that, that's about the only thing that I can possibly fathom out that he might have done and dislocated the shoulder, or rather the elbow at that particular point. But there's no question he was in severe pain, because when the ring physician touched above the elbow in different areas around there, you could see that he was really grimacing and in serious pain. So Rocky Cassiani isn't the type of guy that would quit. He was hurting. And as you saw, that he was practically defenseless there. So it'll be scored again as a TKO victory for Diego Corrales as his comeback continues.